我们开始第75课的学习 SOS 呼救信号。Now first look at the new words and expressions. Follow me, please. Seek, seek, signal, signal, stamp, stamp, helicopter, helicopter, seen, seen, survivor.Survivor. OK, number one is thick. Thick 这个词可以做形容词，表示厚的。那么反义词是薄的。OK, thin. Thick 表厚的 ，thin 表示薄的，是对反义词。For example, this board is the thickest of all. This board is the thickest of all. 这个木板是最厚的。那么 thick 最高级是 thickest 加 est. OK.Thickest, 最厚的。This board is the thickest of all. 这个木板是最厚的。好，再比如说一本厚书 ,a thick book, a thick book, 一本厚书。很厚的墙壁是 thick walls, thick walls, 很厚的墙壁。Another phrase is ice 10 centimeters thick. Ice 10 centimeters thick, 10厘米厚的冰。OK.Thick 第一含义表示厚的，反义词是薄的 thin。那么 thick 还能做形容词，表示粗的、粗大的，反义词还是 thin， 表示纤细的。比如说很粗的线是 a thick line， a thick line 表示很粗的线。另外，粗大的手指是 thick fingers， thick fingers 表示粗大的手指。那么 thick 做形容词。另外一个含义表示液体或者气体等浓的、浓厚的。那么稀薄的是 thin， thin 含义表稀薄的。For example, this sauce is too thick. This sauce is too thick. 这个调味汁太浓了。OK, this sauce too thick. 这个调味汁太浓了。那么很浓的汤是 thick soup. Thick soup.很浓的汤，浓雾大雾是 a thick fog， a thick fog 表示浓雾大雾的意思。 thick 另外一层含义表示树林、树叶或者毛发等密的、浓密的，那么反义词还是 thin， 表示很稀疏的。 For example, a thick forest 翻译成茂密的树林， a thick forest 翻译成茂密的树林、茂密的森林。头发很浓密是 thick hair， thick hair 表示浓密的头发。那么关于 thick 还有一些短语， for example， give a person a thick ear， give a person a thick ear， 在英国口语中间表示给某人一个耳光，通常表示把耳朵打肿。 give a person a thick ear 表示给某人一个耳光，通常表示把耳朵打肿。那么另外一个短语是 through thick and thin， through thick and thin 表示经历过艰难困苦无论什么状况的含义。 OK， through thick and thin 表示经历艰难困苦无论什么状况。 OK， thick 作为形容词有以上含义，表示厚的、粗的、粗大的，液体或者气体浓的、浓厚的，或者树林、树叶或者毛发等密的、浓密的。那么 thick 加 en 之后变成动词 thicken， 是个动词，表示使变厚、使变粗、使变浓等。而名词是 thickness， thickness 是个名词形式。 OK， 另外一个复合形容词 thick-headed 表示笨头笨脑的、傻里傻气的。 thick-headed 笨头笨脑的、傻里傻气的。 OK， 好，我们回顾一下 thick 用法。 This board is the thickest of allA thick book, thick walls, ice 10 centimeters thick, a thick line, thick fingers. This sauce is too thick, thick soup, a thick fog, a thick forest, thick hair. Give a person a thick ear, through thick and thin, thicken, thickness.Thick-headed. is signal. Signal 作为名词表示信号、暗号的意思。比如说，遇难信号是 a distress signal。a distress signal 表示遇难信号，而危险信号是 a danger signal。a danger signal 表示危险信号。好，比如说 ，She gave the signal of emergency。She gave the signal of emergency， 她发出紧急情况的暗号。OK，signal 作为名词可以表示信号、暗号的意思。那么 signal 作名词还能表示信号器或者交通信号。比如说，交通信号失灵了 ，The traffic signal wasn't working。The traffic signal wasn't working， 交通信号失灵了。OK，signal 作名词还能表示信号器、交通信号的含义。那么 signal 还能做动词，表示发信号、以信号通知的意思。signal 可以直接加名词来表达。For example, how can we signal that rowboat? How can we signal that rowboat? Rowboat 表划船的意思。那么我们怎么能发信号通知那个划船呢？ How can we signal that rowboat? 我们怎么能够发信号通知那个划船呢？而 signal orders 表示以信号下达命令。signal orders 以信号下达命令。那么用信号发送消息是 signal a message。signal message 用信号发送消息。OK,signal 可以做及物动词加名词做宾语。那么另外一个结构是 signal to somebody to do something。signal to somebody to do something。表示向某人发信号，表示示意要做某事。signal to somebody to do something， 向某人发信号，示意去做某事。For example， He signaled to the band to stop playing。He signaled to the band to stop playing。band 表乐队的含义。OK， 他向乐队做出手势，开始演奏。He signaled to the band 翻译成。他向乐队做出手势，开始演奏。那么 signal to somebody 后面还能加 that 从句 ，signal to somebody that 表示向某人发信号，声称向某人发信号说的含义。我们来看个例句 ：She signaled to the other girls that everything was all right. She signaled to the other girls that everything was all right. 她对其他女孩子发信号说一切正常。OK。对某人发信号声称说是 signal to somebody that。 OK， 好，以上 signal 作为名词以及动词用法，我们来回顾一下例句。 A distress signal， A danger signal， She gave the signal of emergency， The traffic signal wasn't working。 Signal 加名词做宾语。 How can we signal that rowboat？ Signal orders。Signal a message. Signal to somebody to do something. He signaled to the band to stop playing. Signal to somebody that. She signaled to the other girls that everything was all right. Okay. Next one is stamp. Stamp 在本文中做动词，表示跺脚的含义。那么 stamp 可以表示跺脚。跺地板等等跺脚的动作。For example, 他气得直跺脚。He stamped his feet in anger. He stamped his feet in anger. 或者说 He stamped his feet with anger. 他气得直跺脚。好，再比如说他很不耐烦，在房间里面踱着足来回走动。He stamped about the room impatiently. He stamped about the room impatiently.他很不耐烦，在房间里面踱着足来回走动。OK， 另外一个句子是，他踏着重重的步子走上楼梯。She stamped upstairs. She stamped upstairs. Stamp 本身表跺脚的意思，那翻译成他踏着重重的步子走上楼梯。She stamped upstairs. OK， 非常形象的一个句子。那么 stamp 除了跺脚之外呢，还能表示用力踩住、踩坏的意思。好，比如说不要踩死昆虫，昆虫是 insect， insect， don't stamp on insects， Don't stamp on insects. 不要踩死昆虫。Another example is, the naughty boys stamped the grass flat. The naughty boys stamped the grass flat. Flat 是个形容词，表示扁的。那些顽皮的男孩子踩坏了草坪。The naughty boys stamped the grass flat. 那些顽皮的男孩子踩坏了草坪。好，以上 stamp 作为动词表示跺脚、踩扁、踩坏的意思。那么 stamp 我们最常的含义是名词表邮票的意思。比如说，我的嗜好是收集邮票。My hobby is collecting stamps. My hobby is collecting stamps. 我的嗜好是收集邮票。那么 stamp 还能表示印章、戳记的意思。比如说，橡皮章是 a rubber stamp. A rubber stamp.表示橡皮章，日期印是 a date stamp, a date stamp. OK, 好，以上 stamp 做名词以及动词含义，我们来回顾一下例句。He stamped his feet in anger. He stamped his feet with anger. He stamped about the room impatiently. She stamped upstairs. Don't step on insects.The naughty boys stamped the grass flat. My hobby is collecting stamps. A rubber stamp. A date stamp. Okay, next one is helicopter. Helicopter 表示直升飞机的含义，在口语中简称为 copter. Okay, for example, a helicopter was flying about the school. A helicopter was flying about the school. 一架直升飞机在学校上空飞行。OK, 好 ,helicopter 这个词表直升飞机在口语中简称为 copter。我们的例句是 ,A helicopter was flying about the school. OK, let's go on. Next one is scene. Scene 在本文中表示现场、地点的意思。好，比如说他们冲到了交通事故的现场。交通事故是 the traffic accident. The traffic accident, 表示交通事故。They rushed to the scene of the traffic accident. 他们冲到交通事故的现场。They rushed to the scene of the traffic accident. 好 ,scene 表示现场、地点的意思。那么 scene 还能做名词表示光景、景色、风景的意思，是个可数名词。For example, a beautiful scene from the top of the mountain. A beautiful scene from the top of the mountain.从山顶看到的美丽景色 ,OK? Scene 表示可数名词光景、景色、风景的意思。好 ,another example is, The night scene in Honolulu was quite fantastic. The night scene in Honolulu was quite fantastic. Honolulu 表示檀香山。那么句子翻译成檀香山的夜景绝佳 ,OK? Scene 可数名词表景色、风景的意思。那么 scene 还能表示戏剧、小说等的场面、舞台、地点的含义。For example, The last scene of the play was very impressive. The last scene of the play was very impressive. 这部戏的最后一个场面令人印象深刻。Impressive 是个形容词，表示令人印象深刻的。The last scene of the play was very impressive. OK, 好，再比如说。The scene of that movie is set in Paris in the 1920s. The scene of that movie is set in Paris in the 1920s. 好，其中 the 1920s 表示二十世纪的二十年代。The 1920s 在二十世纪二十年代。OK, 那部电影的背景设于二十世纪二十年代巴黎。那部戏的背景设于二十世纪二十年代的巴黎。OK, scene 表示戏剧、小说等的场面。舞台、地点的含义 ,OK。好，关于 scene 一些短语是 behind the scenes, behind the scenes, 表示在幕后的或者秘密的。Come on the scene, 在口语中间表示出现、登场的含义。Come on the scene, 在口语中间表示出现、登场的含义。另外一个短语是 make a scene, 指大吵大闹的含义。Make a scene, 指大吵大闹的含义。而 on the scene 口语中表示在现场、当场的意思。OK, 那么 scene 可以做名词，表示现场、地点或者光景、景色、风景以及场面、舞台、地点的含义。后面加 ry 之后 ，scenery 也是个名词，表风景的意思。通常是个不可数名词，表示某地区的风景。OK，scenery 不可数名词，表示某地区的风景。好，比如说，阿尔卑斯山脉的风景是 the scenery of the Alps。The scenery of the Alps 指阿尔卑斯山脉的风景。好，再比如说，这的景色很美。The scenery is beautiful around here。The scenery is beautiful around here。这的景色很美。那么形容词风景如画的是 scenic。Scenic 形容词表示风景如画的。For example, a scenic spot 表示风景胜地。A scenic spot 表示风景胜地。OK? 好，我们回顾一下 scene 以及一些相关词汇用法。Scene. They rushed to the scene of the traffic accident.A beautiful scene from the top of the mountain. The next scene in Honolulu was quite fantastic. The last scene of the play was very impressive. The scene of that movie is set in Paris in the 1920s. Behind the scenes. Come on the scene. Make a scene. On the scene. Scenery. The scenery of the Alps.The scenery is beautiful around here. Scenic. A scenic spot. Next one is survivor. Survivor 是个名词，表示生存者、幸存者。OK, 一定注意，以 OR 结尾的 survivor 表示生存者、幸存者。那么动词的幸存、生存是 survive. Survive 是个动词，表示经历灾难之后还活着，由什么事故中生还的意思。For example, only one baby survived the terrible car crash. Only one baby survived the terrible car crash. 在那次可怕的撞车事故中间，只有一个婴儿生还了。好，再比如说 ，few houses in this district have survived after the storm. 本地区暴风雨过后，残留下来的房屋寥寥无几。Few houses in this district have survived after the storm.本地区暴风雨过后，残留下来的房屋寥寥无几。那么 survive 是个动词，表示幸存的意思。名词幸存存活是 survival。好，注意，去掉 e 加 al 之后， survival 是个名词，不可数名词，表示幸存存活的意思。OK， 好，以上是 survivor 幸存者， survive 动词幸存，以及 survival 名词用法。我们来回顾一下例句。Survivor, survive. Only one baby survived the terrible car crash. Few houses in this district have survived after the storm. Survival. Okay, that's worse. Okay, now follow me once again, please. 我们通过阅读单词回顾一下刚刚讲的这些词的哪些重要用法。Follow me, please. Seek, seek, signal, signal.Stamp, stamp, helicopter, helicopter, scene, scene, survivor, survivor.